Companies are handing over hiring decisions to AI. The problem? Turns out these models are just as biased as your most opinionated uncle. But instead of ranting, they respond with the confidence of a consultant who charges $5,000 an hour. A new research paper tested the latest AI models and found something that should scare you. These AIs showed clear cognitive biases, just like humans. The more advanced the model, the more biased it was. And even when researchers tried prompt tricks to fix the bias, nothing worked. I'll link to that research paper in the comments. For the skeptics who think I'm exaggerating, go ahead and read it for yourself. But here's the big takeaway. Companies aren't just using AI to sort resumes. They're handing it the keys to decisions across healthcare, finance, security, and more. And if these systems are worse at thinking clearly than a politician at a charity event, we've got a problem. Let's dig into what the research actually found, because this isn't just theory. It's tested, measured, and kind of terrifying. First, prompting doesn't fix it. Researchers tried multiple techniques with fancy names like chain of thought, ignore the anchor prompts, and reflection strategies. None of them made a statistically significant difference. The bias stuck around. Second, the smarter the AI, the worse the bias. They tested GPT 3.5, 4-aught mini, and 4-aught. And guess what? The most advanced model, GPT 4-aught, was the most biased, showing 30% more skewed decision-making than 3.5. Finally, the types of bias, anchoring and framing. That means AIs can be swayed just by how something is worded. Imagine losing a job interview because your resume said managed instead of led. That's not intelligence, that's linguistic prejudice. That's just the kind of issue this could cause in hiring. Now imagine this same flawed thinking being used in healthcare, finance, or even criminal justice. This isn't a niche problem. It's creeping into every high-stakes decision space out there. Now look, I'm not saying you should stop using AI. That ship has sailed. Companies are going to use it. You're going to use it. I use it. The danger is using it blindly. So if you want to stay smart while working with AI, here are four ways that I actually use it to make better decisions without letting it run the show. Number one, brainstorm at scale. Don't ask AI for 3 ideas. Ask it for 50. The first 10 will be predictable. The next 20 will be weird. Somewhere in there, gold. It's like rapid fire ideation with no judgment, and it'll unlock creative ideas you wouldn't find alone. Two, run a pre-mortem. If you're close to making a big decision, try this. Ask AI, it's 1 year later and this went terribly wrong. What happened? You'll get imaginary disaster stories that surface risks you didn't think to consider. This is actually one of the tools I discussed in my playlist on decision traps, how to spot hidden risks before you make the call. I'll drop the link to that playlist in the comments right next to the research paper. Number three, don't ask for validation. Ask for critique. Never ever ask AI, do you like this idea? It'll say yes, every time. Instead, say, pretend you're a New York Times critic. Review this like a harsh op-ed. Suddenly, your feedback gets 10 times sharper. Four, ask for sources, then check them. When AI gives you a fact, ask, where did you get that? Then check the source, click the link, read the reference. Treat AI like a smart intern. Helpful, fast, but absolutely needs supervision. AI isn't just confident, it's convincing. It doesn't pause, it doesn't doubt, it doesn't warn you when it's wrong. So if you're going to use it to make decisions, especially big ones, don't hand over the wheel. Use it like a teammate, not a boss. Double check everything, and always, always keep your brain in the driver's seat.